Governor, may I have a word, please?
How can I help you, Miss Westfall?
Westfall. Apparently there was a staff briefing this morning. Why was I excluded?
You are not my staff. You were a board appointment.
Technically, yes, but if I'm to function as part of a team, I really feel...
Fine, like as you wish. I will include you in future. Anything else?
I should meet with Smith today, if that's all right with you.
I wasn't aware she'd requested to see a psych.
It is usual procedure after a tough sentencing.
I determine procedure here, Miss Westfall.
Of course, but I think you might be overlooking something.
What would that be?
The board gave me pretty clear KPIs on the prisoner's mental health. I hope you don't intend to obstruct that brief.
You can't have it both ways, Miss Westfall. If you wish to be a member of my team, you'll be reporting to me.
Certainly. So may I proceed?
Be very cautious, Miss Smith. She is a manipulator.
Oh, don't worry, Governor. It's at the forefront of my mind. I'm trained to deal with all types, even those who appear to have their shit together. Can I speak with her?
No.
I want to understand where that aggression's coming from.
Well, I'll tell you where it's coming from. She's a convicted criminal. She threw a pan of boiling oil in somebody's face. She's a drug dealer and a violent delinquent. She is beyond help.
Oh, I disagree. I think there's something else going on.
Your opinion is irrelevant.
The department doesn't think so.
Early days.
How long will she be in there for?
As long as I see fit. Well, that is quite a story.
Yes, it sounds ridiculous.
It's because it is ridiculous, and it is getting more... I do not understand why you're entertaining this. I mean, you do realize that falsely accusing corrections personnel, that carries very serious consequences, yes? Was there something else?
The LSD in her system caused the psychosis, but she's come down now, so I think she is ready for release from the psych unit.
I appreciate your opinion.
Meaning you're ignoring it.
We now have proof that she is a drug user. How can you guarantee that she won't use again at further episodes?
There is no history of drug use. She's been clean since she arrived.
Well, I think the results speak for themselves.
I don't think she took that LSD knowingly.
Meaning what? One of the women spiked her food and drink? Now, whatever the cause, while Smith insists that these delusions are real, she will be kept under observation for her own safety.
You can't keep her restrained indefinitely.
If these delusions persist, she may have to be moved to a proper psychiatric facility.
Right, I can take this to the board, you know. They will listen to me.
Well, if you enjoy the paperwork so much, by all means, go ahead. Frankie Doyle. Her parole hearing is in a matter of weeks. No doubt you are aware of the rumors that have been circulating.
I pay no attention to gossip, Governor.
As a rule, neither do I, but when it comes to incorrect relations between staff and prisoners, I can't afford to ignore it.
There's no truth to it.
I'm merely concerned that Doyle might be exploiting this to influence your report on her.
I'm confident she won't.
Frankie Doyle has a habit of doing things you least expect. She is far too emotional for her own good.
Oh, well, better a surfeit than a deficit.
What does that mean?
Well, a deficit of emotion, particularly a lack of effective empathy, would make you psychopathic. But that's not Frankie. She uses empathy to her advantage.
You think so?
And people are drawn to her because of it.
Does that include you?
I think I've answered that question, Governor. Is that all?
Just out of interest, have you, made any breakthroughs with Doyle?
Breakthroughs?
No insights to report?
My sessions are confidential.
No, I'm just asking if you've learnt anything that might preclude your recommending her release.
Frankie is ready and deserving of parole. Anyone in my position would make the same recommendation.